So guys, today I wanted to do a roasted pepper and tomato soup. And just in case you're wondering what that thing is, it's my roasted pepper that I roasted. You see, now you can see that it's a red bell pepper. I'm roasting it. You can roast it directly on your stovetop and it looks like that. This is what is going to give it that roasted flavor. And now I'm going to stick this in a paper bag. And I'm going to stick it in it and it's going to sweat so that I would be able to get the skin off of the roasted pepper very easily. So once this is in the bag for 2 minutes, I'm going to show you what it looks like. So guys, for our tomato soup, here are the ingredients that I'm going to use. I have about 1/4 cup of sage here. Normally I would use basil, but I don't have basil today, so I'm going to use the sage. It's about 1/4 cup, not tightly packed. This is chopped up fennel. This half a bulb of the fennel. This is half that is chopped up. 2 bay leaf. I have 1 medium-sized red onion that I chopped up. And I have some fresh oregano here. All right. So now we're going to go to the stove and I'm going to start sauteing this for our tomato roasted pepper soup. So I'm going to put some oil in the pot, 3-4 tablespoons. Don't ask me how much. You know I hate measurements. Just put some oil in the pot. Our onions go in. I'm going to put everything in and then I'm going to fish this out. This is a lot of oregano, but it's fresh, so it's not like the dry oregano. Put my fennel in. I'm just going to put everything in and saute it. Let's see how this is going. I think I need some more oil here because it looks a bit dry. So I'm going to add some more oil. So while this is sauteing, this is on medium low. While this is sauteing, I'm going to show you what I'm doing with my red pepper that I roasted. Remove this from here. All right, so let me show you what I did with the peppers. This is a pepper that I put in the paper bag. What you're doing is you want the pepper to sweat. So that once it sweats, you see how the skin is coming off very easily. The blackened skin is coming off. And this roasting is going to really give the pepper, you know, it's going to enhance the flavor. And you're going to have this delicious roasted flavor in your soup. Roasted pepper with tomatoes, it really, really go good together. So this is all you do. Once you could also cover this in a dish, in a bowl. If you don't have a paper bag on hand, you can cover it. The important thing is that it has to sweat so that the skin will come off. So I'll get all of this off and then we'll come back. So we are back and I'm going to show you how I cut this open. Now don't be tempted to wash this off because you're not going to get all of the black stuff off. But this is part of the flavor. You're going to get a lot of flavor from this. Do not wash this off. So you cut this open. And it's very soft because this is cooked. It was cooking as it was roasting, of course. And you're basically just removing the seeds. And then you chop it up. But you don't need to chop it up because I'm going to put this in the food processor with my plum tomatoes. I'm going to use 1 28-ounce can of plum tomatoes and 1 28-ounce can of puree tomatoes for my soup. So all you do is you remove the seeds as much as you can. Do not wash this off because if you wash it off, you're going to be washing off the roasted flavor. So I just wanted to show you this. I'm going to do another pepper. I'm going to show you from the start what I did. So I'm going to get back to you and show you how I do the pepper from scratch. So this is my other pepper. You know, I'm doing two peppers for this soup. It's about this size. So what I do is, like I told you before, when I showed you the one that was roasted, I just sit it on the stovetop like this and you start the roasting process. All right, and you keep turning and turning. So you would, you know, you at some point, you know, this is the stem is going to get hot. So you can turn it with your tongs. You see? So it's already started to roast. When it gets a little bit blackened, I'm going to show you what it looks like. And then you just keep turning it and make sure that it's roasted all over. And that's it. That's how you do it. So I wanted to show you what this looks like. You see, it's blackened on this side. So you keep turning it. So I'm going to turn it and you turn it and turn it. And that's all, guys. That's all you need to roast a pepper. All right, so let's get back to making the soup. I just wanted to show you this is exactly what you do right on your stovetop. It's not a big deal. So I'm going to process my plum tomatoes. So I have one 28-ounce can of plum tomatoes that I'm going to process for my soup. So now I'm going to put in my roasted peppers. And puree this together with the tomato. So I already have my the puree tomato, the 128-ounce can that I put here while I was doing the other things. I'm going to add some pepper flakes to this, pepper and salt to taste. And I'm going to add some sea salt. This is coarse sea salt. 2 teaspoons of coarse sea salt. So this already started cooking and bubbling with my herbs and onions. And now I'm going to add my puree roasted peppers and plum tomatoes that I processed. And what we are going to do next, we have to add water to this because we're making soup. This is not marinara sauce, this is soup. So we have to add water to this. So what I want to do is, I'm going to add 2 of these cans, the 28-ounce cans of water to this. I hope this pot is big enough, but this is what I want to do. So I added 4 cups of water to my 2 cans of tomatoes, puree and plum tomatoes. This is another a cup that I'm going to add. So 4.5 cups of water. And this is a good consistency here. So you need to cook this for 45 minutes. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to fish out everything, the oregano and the bay leaf, and then I'm going to do the immersion blender thing. All right? And I also have to add my other roasted tomato that I did not add yet. So I'll get back to you when this is done. So this soup has been cooking for about 1 hour. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to fish out the stems from the oregano and the bay leaf. And the big pieces, even the onions, because the flavors are already in there. But I want to fish out mostly the bay leaf and the oregano. And then I'm going to immersion blend this. Okay, so I think I have, oh, this got back in there. I need this little stalk here. And what I was also thinking, maybe we can put some Brazil nut milk in here, and you have like a cream tomato soup. Cream tomato soup, that's a good idea. I just had this idea. So you can put some Brazil nut milk, but that's optional. So now I'm going to blend this up. And it's such a beautiful color. It's a bright orange because of the roasted peppers. So this is done, guys. It does look creamy. That the immersion blender does that. This is delicious. I've done this before. I hope you do this for your family, and you can serve this for dinner with some bread and a salad, you know, and you're good to go. All right, so take care, guys, and don't forget to like and subscribe.